This week on Cal High Sports Bay Area, the league races are heating up, and we have the big game highlights. We'll see 5-1 Moreau Catholic take on Kennedy, Valley Christian hosts St. Francis, and Woodside battles Menlo.
We have great league volleyball action with Midi and St. Francis, water polo with De La Salle and Amador Valley. We continue the season with De La Salle football as the Spartans meet San Ramon Valley, and the Ensenal football player who lost both his parents, now he's keeping the dream alive, next on Cal High Sports Bay Area.
Welcome to Cal High Sports Bay Area here at the Silver Creek Sportsplex. I'm Robert Brownstein.
And I'm Marissa Lovis. We start this week in Oakley, where Bay Valley League play begins this week. Two teams expected to fight for a league title, Pittsburgh and Freedom, meeting Friday night.
And Pittsburgh is led by outstanding senior quarterback Christian Young, who's thrown for better than 1,000 yards this season. Freedom also likes to throw the ball, and they have a fine senior quarterback as well, and Joe Sweeney, who's thrown for more than 1,100 yards. It's a shootout to open Bay Valley League play.
The Freedom Dance Team showing off their spirit while supporting Breast Cancer Awareness Month. First quarter, and we are scoreless, but Pitt would change that as quarterback Christian Young rolls right and hits Namonte Grisby for the score, 7-0 Pirates. Freedom would answer right back as outstanding senior running back Ronnie Rivers takes it through the middle, breaks away to the outside, and dives for the pylon. He's in, and we are tied at 7. Second quarter now, same score when Falcon quarterback Joseph Sweeney connects with his favorite target, Gio Faulo, who will do the rest. He makes a man miss and dashes 41 yards to the house, and it's 14-7 Birds. 14-10 now, and Pittsburgh would retake the lead on this give to Montez Thompson, who takes it in from 3 yards out, 17-10 Pitt. Freedom comes back, and Gio Faulo, you've got to be kidding. He makes the one-handed stick, and he's down at the one. Rivers would punch it in from there to retake the lead. And the Falcons would fall back behind, however, so they need some Sweeney to connect with Rivers on the swing. He tiptoes the sideline, and Freedom goes up with just over a minute left. Pitt needs to make a huge play as Young hits sophomore Ajay Boyd over the middle, who makes four different Falcons miss and gets some huge blocks along the way, and he is gone. 44 yards to the Pater, and the Pittsburgh Pirates win a wild one as Coach Vic Galley becomes the winningest coach in school history with his 114th win.
Sacred Heart Prep Class of 2019 showing off their float at homecoming. Nicely done by the freshmen. Quarterback Mason Randall dropping back to pass. He's flushed out of the pocket and takes a shot downfield off his back foot and finds a wide open receiver. Nick O'Donnell hauls it in. 7-0 Gators. Randall back at it again with the play action pass this time, floating it over the middle and finding big tight end Cameron Dulski in the seam. And Cameron rumbles his way into the end zone. It's another 6 for the Gators. Randall really starting to find a rhythm, looking for his big play man O'Donnell. And he hits him on the sideline, taking it all the way down to the 10-yard line. And that sets up this handoff to running back Lapitu Mahoney, who just walks into the end zone untouched, opening up a 21-0 lead. The Tigers looking to get something going. It's quarterback Joey Pledger dropping back and heaving it across the middle, finding receiver Tyler Shores, who hangs on after a big hit, setting his team up for a punch-in touchdown. But Randall would get right back into it, marching downfield and throwing a beautiful touch pass to Andrew Doshbach, who takes it in for another score through the air. Wanting to share the love, the Gators hand it off to Mahoney, who finds a huge hole. He's going down the sideline and shedding the last tackler. Sacred Heart Prep wins the league opener big, 47-13.
Contra Costa County Sports is brought to you by StatMed Urgent Care. The right care, right now. No lack of excitement poolside as the Campolindo girls hosted Alcalanes. The visitors would get things rolling off the bat. Henna Kresnick delivers a long feed out to Maddie Stewart, who takes her time and gets the Dons on the board. 1-0. 2-0 now, and Campo would respond. Aaron Newstrom rises up from the outside and skips it into the back of the net to cut the deficit in half. And Alcalanes would strike right back. Emma and Miles squeezes this one right inside the post for the goal, and the lead is back to 2. More Dons offense. Great ball movement here as Miles crosses it to Brooke Alstrin, who spots Lexi roll open in the middle, and it's 4-2 Dons. The Cougars claw back, though, as this great individual effort by Olivia Price, who gets Campo within 6-4. Tied at 6 now, and it's Moore Price. Her penalty shot gives Campo their first lead with only 2:30 left. And under a minute now, the Dons looking to answer. The first shot is denied, but Bella Winslow is right there to punch in the rebound. And we go to OT, second overtime session with Campo trailing by one, just seconds left. Zoe Crouch has no choice but to let it fly, and she connects. The freshman comes up huge, and we go to sudden death, where Akalanis would get the last laugh as Krusnik spots Rowley, catches and shoots in one motion, and the Dons hold off the furious Campolindo comeback and win it in a thriller 9-8 in Triple OT. Each week we bring you the Players of the Week, brought to us in a wrap produced by the Hip Hop Department at the Rikers Center.
Here are this week's Players of the Week.
Ladies and gentlemen,
hello.
This is your Cal High Players of the Week, brought to you by Rikers Center. Yep. From the NCS, we got Ray Jackson, 200 plus yards. Woo. During that action, multiplying these wins, no subtraction. Adding all these carries is just a fraction of his impact, his interaction. Woo. On the field,
nope.
There's no distraction. You can teach heart,
nope.
You can teach passion,
nope.
Cashing touchdowns, every run is a transaction. Now everybody has been talking about Bellarmine, sinking their opponents fast like they submarines. In control of the missiles is Troy Mertzek. They can stop the run, and now boy they mad. 3 touchdowns and 21 carries, let it fly like a bird, more than one Larry. 156 yards for the quarterback. He put 2 cents in and get a dollar back. Those are your Players of the Week.
Your orthopedic specialists bring us great advice each week on sports-related injuries. Here's Dr. Matthew Pecci with this week's health tip.
Getting the wind knocked out of you is a commonly used phrase referring to a direct blow to the abdomen, which causes release of the air in the lungs. The blow can also cause spasm of the abdominal muscles, which make it difficult to breathe. While this can cause anxiety and panic, usually recovery occurs within a few minutes. Drawing the knees up to the chest to relax the abdominal muscles and slowly breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth may also be helpful. Most often, the athlete can return to sports within a few minutes after they catch their breath. However, if symptoms persist, it may indicate a more serious internal injury, and it is advised to seek further medical advice.
Coming up, a battle of undefeated teams as Aragon meets Burlingame in the Togo's Monster Game.
And the Ins and Out football star chasing a dream in our Stevens Creek Toyota Spirit of Achievement feature next.
Muir Orthopedic Specialist, the leader in innovative sports medicine, is proud to present its new 46,000 square foot facility in Walnut Creek. This new leading edge facility combines high-tech equipment, an Olympic weightlifting area, indoor turf field for training and rehab, and expanded physical therapy facilities. The new Muir Orthopedic Facility features efficient and personalized check-in, spacious reception areas, and on-site digital x-rays for fast results. For the best care for your treatment and recovery, visit the doctors at Muir Orthopedic Specialists.
The Rikers Center for Human Enhancement offers a range of programs in the athletic fitness department designed to train athletes of all ages and abilities. Our programs range from Rise Up for student athletes 9 and older to Pinnacle and Team Training sessions for more advanced athletes with a specific far-reaching goal. Or sign up for CORE and get a customized workout plan designed for whatever intensity or ability level you want to achieve. From Pinnacle to CORE, the Rikers Center has a program to help you achieve your goals. So it's simple. If you've got goals, come to the Rikers Center.
It's a new season at Stevens Creek Toyota, and we're proud to present this year's all-star lineup. Like home run deals on Camry, the original Swagger Wagon Sienna, and our number one player, better than par, Prius. Plus, experience genuine Toyota service in our state-of-the-art facility. They're all here, your hometown champs, only at Stevens Creek Toyota San Jose. Visit us online at StevensCreekToyota.com.
We are back at the Silver Creek Sportsplex with opening night action in the Peninsula Bay Division. Both Aragon and Burlingame coming into this game with perfect 4-0 records.
Now, neither team faced a really tough test in the first four games, but Friday night would be different as the teams faced a huge test in the league opener. It's our Togo's Monster Game, and our Jack Washer was there.
Monster Game, yeah.
Opening night in the Peninsula Bay Division as Burlingame and Aragon both come in with 4-0 records. Should be a good one. These two teams play with contrasting playing styles. Aragon liking to air it out with Tanner Nguyen, averaging more than 250 yards in the passing game. And with Burlingame, we talk about LaPelli Palu, the bone-crushing runs he has game in and game out. But Giovanni Garcia having the ability to make an impact on the ground, through the air, and also on special teams. Watch him in the kicking game. Should be a good one. It's Burlingame. It's Aragon. It's a Togo's Monster game. It's a big game. Let's go. Right to the action we go. Burlingame on the attack. Cameron Kaleda hits Ben Williams in space, and Williams gains 28 yards into Don's territory. But on fourth down, Aragon's defense makes a stand. Devin Grant steps into the passing lane, and there he goes down the sidelines. Finally dragged down, but not before a great return into Panther territory. That will lead to this. Val Wilson, short touchdown run, and Aragon grabbed a 7-0 lead. Second quarter, Aragon back on the move. Nguyen hands to Gabe Campos. It's a halfback pass deep to wide open. Mr. Devin Grant, 64 yards down to the 1-yard line. Don's punching in one play later. On the ensuing kickoff, Giovanni Garcia takes it from his one. We said watch him to make plays in the kicking game. Well, there you go. Look at him go. 99 yards to the house and gets Burlingame back into the game. Panthers would tie it at 14 going into the locker room. Third quarter, Panthers plunge ahead, handed to LaPelli Palu, and Palu dives into the end zone to put Burlingame up 21-14. Don's come right back, though. Nguyen to Wilson on the screen pass, finds a seam, and there he goes. 48 yards on the pitch and catch. Don scores a short time later to tie the score at 21. Late in the fourth now, Burlingame with first and goal, handed to the big guy, Palu, and he paves his way into the end zone to put the Panthers up 28-21. Panthers trying to put the game on ice, and they do. Palu, 26 yards, untouched, and the Burlingame Panthers go on to win by a final score of 35-21.
It gives us hope and faith, you know. Some of us, including me, got injured, and then our second strings and third strings stepped up today, did pretty well. You know, if I can't do it, then I know my second strings and third strings could do it. You know, we just have a great team, and we have faith in our team.
In Burlingame with the Monster Game, I'm Jack Washer, Cal High Sports Bay Area.
Ranked 17th in the nation, the Los Gatos Wildcats looking to stay undefeated against second-place Saratoga. First half, the Cats on the short corner. Hannah Harrington gets it inside to Ava Verigen. She's a freshman. Later in the half, short corner again, Allie Hilliard out to Lauren Verhaden, who rockets it off a defender and in. 2-0 Wildcats. More Cats in the first. Sydney Miller with a dive keeps the play alive to Hannah Harrington, who lifts it past the keeper, and Los Gatos is cruising with a 3-0 lead. Second half, the ball in front to Sophie Camo. A nice pass to a cutting Verhaden in front where Sarah Deck hits the deck, diving and firing, and Deck scores to make it 4-0 Los Gatos. Saratoga gets on the board here as Tina Miller, working hard, gets it to Kelsey Kinoshita, and she scores and was really happy about it. Later, the Cats get one more as Sarah Deck gets it ahead to Camo, and Sophie's been doing this for many years as Los Gatos moves to 5-0 in league, 8-0 overall for the defending CCS champs.
Each week, Stevens Creek Toyota brings the stories of athletes who have overcome adversity in their lives to succeed in school and in sports.
Marissa, tonight we meet the outstanding defensive back for the Ensenal Jets. Akil Francisco is the second generation to attend Ensenal. His father's legacy allows the students at Ensenal to dream. On the edge of the San Francisco Bay on the island of Alameda is the Ensenal football field, part of a high school built when there was still an Air Force base in Alameda. Why Ensenal is the Jets. Today, one of the fastest Jets on the football team is defensive back and wideout Akil Francisco. Akil is part of Ensenal's history. His dad was also a Jet. Mike Dream Francisco was a graffiti artist known as Dream. His crew was TDK, or Those Damn Kids. But this was art, and Dream became known around the world for his work.
No Justice, No Peace represents the outcry of young teenagers out here in the community today who are releasing their anger through this media, through graffiti, you know what I'm saying?
My father, you know, was talented with the spray can, but he was also political with his art as well. And a lot of people respected him. Not only for the graffiti art, but for his personality as well. You know, from all the stories I heard, he was a real good guy and a real true friend as well, everybody else as well.
Dream did good work in the community, often donating his talents, producing a mural for a charity. In 2000, Dream was killed in West Oakland.
Well, he was out visiting a friend out in West Oakland. This was February of 2000. And he basically got, it was an armed robbery. They robbed him, they took his, they demanded his gold chain and his bracelet, I believe. And he put up a fight, and that's when they shot him multiple times. And he just died on the scene.
When Dream died, Akil was just 10 months old. He stayed with his mom, and with the help of his uncle, Akil pressed on. 10 years later, Akil's mom, his best friend, died from breast cancer.
It hurts a lot to have somebody pass away from breast cancer, and then to watch them pass away from that. It's just, it's only so much you can do to help, you know, to help them. And most I could do is just be by her side and let her know I'm here for her.
At 10 years old, with Dream and his mom now gone, Akil was raised by his uncle and grandparents.
Recently, you know, I just lost my grandmother also to breast cancer too. So, you know, it's hard. Breast cancer is really hard to deal with.
But for Akil, there is still a dream in his life. He wants to go to college to play football or run track. To do that, he knows he has to have top grades, and he does, carrying a 4.0 with all A's. Akil is shining in the classroom. On the field, Akil is also a star.
Well, right now, I think that he's one of the top DBs in the Bay Area. I think through four games, he's only allowed one reception. And I think he's just going to get better and better. He's got a big offseason coming up after this year, and we'll definitely know from them. But from what I've seen throughout his sophomore year and junior year, definitely think he can play at the next level.
This mural on the Encinal campus is a memorial to Dream, something Akil sees every day. But he doesn't need a reminder of his mom and dad. He thinks of them all the time. They are his motivation to succeed, a way to keep the dream alive. You can get more information at mikedream.com, including ways to help Akil achieve his dreams.
Glad to see he's doing well and playing football.
And just a fine young man.
Absolutely. Once again this season, the San Francisco 49ers present the Coach of the Week Award with $1,000 going to the winning coach.
Here is the 49ers' Ian Williams with this week's announcement.
Hi, I'm 49ers defensive lineman Ian Williams, here to announce the Charlie Wiedemeyer Memorial Coach of the Week. This week's award goes to head coach Mark Crail from Los Gatos High School. Crail's Wildcats came out on top on Friday night's offensive thriller, outlasting Wilcox 42-32, handing them their first loss of the season. It was a close game with 7 lead changes, but ultimately came down to turnovers. Los Gatos forced 3 turnovers on the night, 2 of which resulted in touchdowns for the Wildcats. Coach Crail will be invited to watch a 49ers practice at the SAP Performance Facility, where he will be presented his award by Coach Tom Sula. He will also be recognized on the field prior to our final home game on January 3rd. As part of this award, Los Gatos High School will receive a $1,000 grant from the 49ers Foundation. Congratulations to head coach Mark Crail. This week's Charlie Wiedemeyer's Coach of the Week.
Coming up, the battle for Santa Clara as Wilcox meets Santa Clara.
But first, here is our Chevron Girls Volleyball Poll.
Little Kickers is a great soccer program for your child. With coaches trained in child development theory, Little Kickers classes are tailored to meet the specific child's age and ability. This creative approach to coaching will have a positive impact on your child far beyond the soccer field. These fun, high-energy classes at the Silver Creek Sportsplex lead to children with strong physical skills who are well-balanced and confident. Classes are available now for ages 18 months to 9 years. Sign up for Little Kickers at the Silver Creek Sportsplex today.
Guys, I got the jerseys. Oh, yeah. El Nino.
Aquí.
Spray Dan.
Oh, yeah.
Don Ovan.
Think that's me?
You guy. It's $40. Can you cover that?
I'll send it to you right now. Done.
Okay, got it. So Hattrick Rick, he's the best player on our team. You get the ball, you give it to him.
Great. Rick.
On your phone, online, on the go, Wells Fargo makes it easy to get banking done.
All right, Don, you're on. Nope, just kidding.
When an athlete is injured, you need the right help right away. StatMed Urgent Care has only experienced medical specialists on duty 7 days a week. With no appointment needed, on-site x-ray labs, and private exam rooms, you'll receive the best possible care right away.
For immediate medical issues to routine care, StatMed has two locations in downtown Lafayette and in the Pleasant Hill Concord area near the Sun Valley Mall. StatMed Urgent Care, the right care right now.
Back at the Sportsplex with the big rivalry game in the city of Santa Clara as the Bruins from Santa Clara High take on arch rival Wilcox.
Both teams playing very well this season. The Bruins undefeated with sophomore quarterback Chris Brown leading the way. Wilcox is 3-1 with Manu Turituri and Eduardo Andretti leading a solid running attack. The battle for Santa Clara Friday night.
The Wilcox Chargers cheerleaders all excited for this crosstown rivalry. The Chargers starting the game off strong. It's Manu Turituri charging his way into the end zone. It's a 7-0 lead. On the next drive, it's 4th-and-5. The Chargers decide to go for it. Option pitch to Turituri. He leaps over the tackler for the first down, allowing the Chargers to follow up with a touchdown, 14-0. Dominating on offense, the Chargers strike like lightning with quarterback Eduardo Andrade throwing a post pass. It's caught by Hezekiah Tali Finefia Ukai, who speeds his way into the end zone for another Wilcox touchdown. Santa Clara gets some momentum going. It's quarterback Chris Brown with a screen to Marquise Shields. Marquise cuts in and then turns on the burners, using his incredible speed to get past all the defenders. 84 yards for the Bruins. Touchdown. The Bruins keep it going with another pass to Shields. This time downfield, it's caught. He powers past 3 tackle attempts before striding his way for another touchdown for the Bruins in the fourth quarter. But the Wilcox Chargers were just too far ahead, ending the night strong with a long pass to Andrew Rodriguez, caught at the edge of the end zone, and Wilcox goes on to win it. 55-27 was the final. Wilcox now 4-1 on the season.
East Bay League matchup as De La Salle travels to Amador Valley Thursday night. First quarter, the Spartans' Jake Simpson taking his time before rising up and placing it perfectly to the corner of the net to give DLS the first score of the game. Second quarter, still 1-0 De La Salle. It's Simpson again capitalizing on the penalty shot to give the Spartans a 2-goal lead, and Amador fighting their way back. Nice passing here by the Dons. The ball finds its way to Jack Naughton, who pinballs it into the net, and Amador Valley is within 1. More DLS to end the second. Tyler Roselli passes to Tristan Noflick, and Noflick is flicking the ball in from around his back. 3-2 Spartans. And after the half, DLS got hot. Noflick to Simpson. Simpson to Seth Barbary, and he slips it past the keeper to put the Spartans up 5-2. And De La Salle not done. Jonathan Bindy with a perfect placement to keep the Spartans rolling in the third. And there was no looking back from there. Shane Jacoby catches the ball and wastes no time putting it in the net. And De La Salle wins this one with a final of 11-6. The Spartans now 4-1 in league with the season over halfway done.
Service by Medallion honors teamwork and teammates who partner together to make great plays. This week we salute the Los Gatos Wildcats as Hunter Biggie throws to Miles Beach, and Miles is headed to the beach, which is just up Highway 17 and over the hill.
Great teamwork from Hunter and Miles, just as Service by Medallion partners with its customers to provide great janitorial service and facility support services for Silicon Valley's best companies. This season, onehitaway.org will have concussion safety tips every week.
Here's Brett Sidibaco with this week's tip.
No matter the game's circumstances, an athlete with a suspected concussion should be immediately removed from play. When in doubt, sit them out. For a coach or trainer, look for signs and symptoms of a concussion if the athlete has experienced a bump or blow to the head or body. Ensure that the athlete is immediately evaluated by an appropriate healthcare professional. One Hit Away understands your brain can change your game.
Coming up, it's the Wells Fargo Bank Game of the Week as Kennedy meets Moreau Catholic.
And later, a West Catholic League tussle as Valley Christian and St. Francis matchup as Cal High Sports Bay Area continues.
Hi, my name's Tom McGraw. I'm the CEO of First National Bank of Northern California and the former Bellarmine Bell. Our bank is owned and operated locally by people who treat our customers like family. You can trust us to give your family or business the best banking services from a bank that's been around for over 50 years. And now we're in Sunnyvale at 425 South Matilda. Remember, go long and don't drop the ball at First National Bank of Northern California.
The San Francisco 49ers are committed to helping kids live a healthy, active lifestyle.
You're plenty fast enough. You're plenty fast. Exchange, exchange. Good, go, 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 go.
Check out 49ers.com/YF to see how you can get involved.
Cal High Sports Bay Area is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. By the Silver Creek Sportsplex, the largest indoor sports and fitness facility of its kind in the United States. Our doors are open to the public every day. Come see why people call us their home away from home. By Club Sport Fitness at the Silver Creek Sportsplex. Visit clubsport.com for a 3-day trial pass. By Chevron, every day your car takes care of you, take care of it. Don't use low-quality gasoline that can leave deposits in the engine. Use the gas that cleans. Chevron with Techron. Care for your car. By Calpine, a generation ahead today. And by the Del Grand Dealer Group. Go to DGDG.com and be a happy car buyer.
Once again this season, Wells Fargo Bank is presenting the Game of the Week. You can go to our website, calhighsportsbayarea.com, right now to vote on next week's game. Each team to receive $500 from Wells Fargo Bank.
And this week, the most votes go to the Moreau Catholic versus Kennedy game, this Mission Valley League matchup of two of the league's best teams, the Wells Fargo Bank Game of the Week, and Marissa was there.
Captains from both Moreau Catholic and Kennedy meeting at the 50, both teams ready for the game. Shane Sanuti getting things started for the Titans. He connects for a nice gain, but just a couple of plays later, it's the Mariners D stepping up big with a sack to end the Kennedy drive. Julius Chong getting in on the QB sack. The Mariners getting going on offense. Ryan Regner spots Johnny Den Blaker. Blaker, quite the talent for Moreau, UCLA bound next season and named to the Army All-American team this week. Same drive for the Mariners. Regner keeping this one for himself. He goes around the outside, scampering in for the first TD of the game to give MC a 7-0 lead. And Moreau features someone very special on their team. He goes by the name of Buddha Ison. Check out one of Buddha's spectacular rushes here. Kennedy would escape, but Buddha was just getting started. Third quarter, the Mariners came out ready to roll. Buddha Ison, only a junior, but one heck of a player. Buddha maneuvering through players, cutting left and right. He's in for 6-14-0 Moreau. MC really looking to their rushing game in the third. It's none other than Buddha dodging Titans, getting upfield. There was no stopping number four. A couple stutter steps this play would lead to another Mariners TD. And we finish off these highlights with another Buddha Ison TD. This guy was making everyone miss the entire night. He breaks free into the open field, and it's the Moreau Catholic Mariners cruising to victory in this one, 34-0, improving to 6-1 overall and 2-1 in league play. Coming off a big win, let's get to know the Moreau Catholic Mariners.
Yeah!
I'm here with Junior Buddha Ison. Buddha, you are just a force on this team. Everyone says you bring so much excitement. Talk about your role.
I play the leader role, you know. I follow behind my linemen, and my linemen make me, they make me go. They make the whole team go. That's all I do, man. That's all I do.
And how were you able to bounce back tonight after last week?
Our coach talked to us a lot about executing. And at practice, we just worked hard on executing, you know, watching a lot of film and our linemen working on their blocks.
And another force on defense is Richard Hampton. Richard, new coach this year for the defense. Talk about how he's really changed the chemistry of your defense.
I mean, we worked, had a pretty good offseason. We focused a lot on just, working hard, hitting hard, and playing as a team. So we did really well at doing that.
And a lot of people are expecting big things out of this Moreau Catholic team. What's the chemistry like this year?
The chemistry is great. There's no tension. We work well as a unit on both sides of the ball. So it's really well. It's fun to play with. It's fun to play with these guys.
And last but not least, we have Johnny Den Blaker. It's not often that you hear we're interviewing the long snapper, but you're headed to UCLA next year. You just got named to the Army All-American team. What's it mean to you?
It means a lot to me. You know, playing here for 4 years, it really feels like, you know, I'm able to step up and help try to put Moreau football on the map.
And how have you been able to perfect your position as long snapper?
Just being dedicated to my craft, you know. Coach Cotter lets me work 24/7 on long snapping. You know, I got support on my team, and, you know, that's really phenomenal.
All right, that does it for us here with the Moreau Catholic Mariners. Guys, take us out with the cheer.
Hey, squad on me, squad on three. 1, 2, 3, squad! Damn, let's go!
Basketball star Peter Hewitt and his friends getting excited for this top water polo matchup. Peter are headed to UC Davis next year. The Gators are good in the water. That's Maddie Johnson, part of the national under-18 team that played in Jamaica this past summer. More Gator shot clock winding down as Malaika Koshy goes over the defender and scores 2-0 Gators. Nice passing by the Lancers here as Julia Hartman goes to Lauren
Lauren Dillon, inside to Katya and Mateos. Still the Gators lead it 4-1. Here's Dillon on the break across the pool to Izzy Mandema, and Izzy is not going to miss from there. It's 4-2. But the Gators would never lose the lead. Here's Nadia Paquin bouncing at home prep up 5-2. Second half, and look at this shot by the Lancers sophomore Mandema, who bounces it in from way out. Izzy making him dizzy. She's one of the nation's best sophomores. But the Gators win it. Nice play here by sophomore Clay Kerrigan, spinning and firing, and Sacred Heart Prep wins it to go to 2-0 in league. 9-6 is the final.
Lex, this is Stevens Creek presents the Volunteer Award each week. This award honors student athletes who volunteer in their community.
This week's Lexus of Stevens Creek volunteer is Spencer Spring from Pioneer High School, a standout player on the water polo team. Spencer is part of a club called San Jose Friends, where he and other members of the club travel to different elementary schools around San Jose and help kids develop their reading skills, showing why athletes offer more than their abilities at their sport. Spencer explains why this is so important.
I do this personally because I think it is a fun experience. I enjoy being in the club and I enjoy working with the kids and seeing their progress.
The San Jose Sharks and Positive Coaching Alliance are back with us this season, honoring triple impact competitors. These are athletes who make themselves better, their teammates better, and the game as a whole better. This week we honor Ronica Stone. The Warriors team captain is a star on the volleyball team going to Oregon next year. She also plays basketball and is a true team leader.
She does not play harmonica or celebrate Hanukkah, but Ronica will receive 4 tickets to an upcoming Sharks game and a replica jersey as this week's triple impact competitor. Coming up, St. Francis and Valley Christian.
And the season with De La Salle as the Spartans look to extend their streak over Bay Area teams when we come back.
Cal High Sports Bay Area is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. By Stevens Creek Toyota, the number one Toyota dealership in the Bay Area. Stevens Creek Toyota, it's where the deals are. By Mir Orthopedic Specialists, providing leading-edge care for athletes of all ages. By First National Bank of Northern California, delivering quality products and services to businesses and individuals while enhancing the economic environment of our communities. And by Catering by Five, outstanding meals for your next party wherever it is. Catering by Five, High Five Pizza, and High Five at the Plex.
Back at the Silver Creek Sportsplex with 2 of the 4 teams still undefeated in the West Catholic League, both St. Francis and Valley Christian stayed perfect with their league opening wins last week.
The Lancers like to run the ball with junior Cyrus Habibi Lukio, while the Warriors' Morian Walker Jr. is having a fine season rushing for VC. Game 2 in the West Catholic League, Friday night.
Valley Christian always serving mouth-watering tri-tip. Oh, it's so good. Early on, St. Francis in control handed to Lutovico Ohoaie, and he barrels ahead for a Lancer first down, and that leads to the first score of the game. Cyrus Habibi Likio weaving his way 47 yards, and it's 7-0 Lancers in the first. The Lancers moving again in the second is Kamali'i Akina, back to throw and finding Jordan Baines, who gets crushed by Anthony Flores, but he hangs on for the first down. And the first down leads to this Ahoye touchdown run, 14-0 St. Francis at halftime. Early third quarter now and handed to Ahoye, who is stopped at the line but somehow bust free, and he is gone. Look at the wheels, 67 yards, and it's a 21-0 St. Francis Lancers lead. Back comes Valley Christian. Javon Stearns into the end zone. The Warriors add a field goal, and it's 21-10 Lancers. 3 minutes to play. The Warriors' Miles Kendrick throwing into the end zone, and there to haul it in is Morian Walker. 2-point conversion fails, and it's 21-16 Lancers. Valley Christian gets the ball back one last chance, but the Lancers' Thomas McDevitt gets the sack to end the game as the Lancers remain unbeaten at 5-0 on the season. Big games for Ahoye and Habibi Likio. The Menlo Atherton Bears take the court ready to take on Carlmont. Both teams looking to stay unbeaten in league. First set, Aaron Alonzo with a huge save. It's set over to Maya McClellan, and she will steer this one down to open up a Scots lead. Bears would go on a run. Game point, Kirby Knapp sets it up high for Jacqueline DeSanto, who hammers it inside the line. MA takes the first. Second set is a blockathon. Carlmont's Elena Mateus is right there for the rejection to keep this set close. The Bears will try for another spike, but it's Alexis Morrow's time to get in on the action, slamming it down for her team. Looking for 3 in a row, Leanna Collins takes a set and blasts it into the wall, but it's too much for the defense this time as The Scots take game two, 25-20. Third set is a thriller match point for the Bears. Sophie Srivastava sets up Mateus in the corner, and she blasts it home to keep her team alive, and we're tied at 24. Match point again, McClellan takes the service for a give and go to herself, and she just gets it over the outstretched arms of the blocker to give her team yet another chance. But the Bears have seen enough. Kiana Sales reaches out for the great diving dig, and Jacqueline DeSanto tips it over the block as the Menlo Atherton Bears remain undefeated with a hard-fought victory.
Each week we go inside Cal High Sports with the Season of De La Salle presented by Muir Orthopedics.
We continue now with our series, The Season with De La Salle Football.
Robert, the De La Salle Spartans have not lost a staggering 263 straight games against Northern California teams. The Spartans put that streak on the line this week as they work hard to keep that history alive.
The Season with De La Salle is presented by Dr. Charles Preston, sports medicine specialist at Muir Orthopedic Specialists, and on the sidelines with the De La Salle Spartans.
Now this is the sound of De La Salle football.
Most of y'all barely even pulling your knee up.
And this is Mike Wine, strength and conditioning coach for the Spartans, the main man in charge of making young men bigger.
Just because we got a game in, what, 2 days, doesn't mean you guys get to go light. All right, let's go. Be hyped up today. Let's go.
Not only are we building frames so that the body can actually handle what it's going to be asked by the athlete, by the coach, by the sport, the demands, we're building that mentality of hard work, work ethic, discipline, focus.
You know, they teach us here, you know, give a perfect effort, you know, push through, do extra reps. Actually, like after the lift, I do extra stuff like split squats, push-ups, and core work. So I just try to enhance what, you know, I can enhance.
I'm here just in case. Come on, lower. You gotta keep the range, gotta keep the range. I'm gonna push you down if you don't keep going down.
Everybody's pushing each other, everybody's competing, and that's what he instills in this whole program. He says that he pushes you to limits that you couldn't think that you could be pushed to. It's great.
Devin Aussie works hard on his body and his craft, and it's paid off. This week, Devin was named to the U.S. Army All-American Bowl.
All-American, Army All-American, that's you. Let's go.
Over the last 4 years, Devin's transformed his frame from wiry athlete to a 6'5", 270-pound force at tight end and deep.
Squat more. Drive. There you go.
You know, I've been working hard ever since, man. I don't know how old I was. I mean, man, it goes all the way back to, like, second grade. I didn't even think about it. But it feels good. It's putting that work and get to that All-American game. It's a blessing.
Standout tackle Boss Tagaloa is a monster in this arena. Boss is dealing with injuries, but there's no sympathy in the weight room.
What happened to your finger?
This thing broke.
You broke your finger? Yeah, dude. We'll get you on bar. Come on, man. You're fine. This is light. One, two, three, up. Let's go. One, two.
And probably less sympathy on the field.
Devin, help him out. Carabias, give him a sling. That thing's vicious. You okay, boss? Shouldn't you be elevating?
De La Salle stands at 5-1 as the Spartans face San Ramon Valley this week. Winners of five straight, DLS is outscoring opponents 215-39 in that span. Impressive numbers, but as De La Salle faces another Northern California squad, those numbers pale in comparison to the Spartans' winning streak against the North State, a mind-boggling 263 games straight.
Yeah, we don't really think about that until you guys bring it up, actually. We've had a pretty good run up here in Northern California lately.
There's a little bit of pressure. I think the good thing about being at De La Salle is our coaches kind of, they do a good job of kind of blinding it out. So rather than worrying about, you know, oh, we got to keep the streak up, you know, it's kind of just like, do your job.
Yeah, you always get pumped up for like the games around here because there's always people talking smack saying that, oh, we'll beat De La Salle. So there's real fire behind the games.
When they say that, what do you think?
You just kind of think, you kind of laugh to yourself. You're like, yeah, right.
The reason for that confidence is the DLS coaches, who are keeping themselves busy this week in preparation for San Ramon.
And Jan, drive him out, good. There you go, hey.
And you gotta push him a little bit so he can push you off that block.
Get like this, here we go.
This is read option, guys. Do not let anybody penetrate.
I want the center and the guard overtaking the three.
All right, let's go.
Let's go, baby.
Let's bring a lot of excitement out there. Let's do some great things.
it's a great, where else would you want to be? The perfect place to be tonight. Let's get out there and do something great.
The Spartans are clicking, but pregame, Coach Edson still wants to see more from the special teams.
That's got to continue. And hopefully, we'll do something on special teams.
And on the opening kick, the special teams and Alex Colon Aguilar deliver for Coach Edson.
Come on! We got the ball!
The ball is loose on the play.
De La Salle recovers the fumble and scores two plays later. And just like that, the route is on.
And the carry goes to Custer over the left side. Custer in the open field. Custer stays on his feet. He's inside the 20. Custer's going to go the distance. Touchdown Spartans, 54 yards for Antoine Custer.
Hey, now that is better. See?
Yeah.
That's a 28 run. The other run was like a little janky JV or something like that, right?
Yeah.
Coach Allenbaugh can't miss with his play calling, and the scores start to pile up.
Yep. Lightning. 3-2-2-3.
Hey, quad trips right shotgun, lead a 9 option.
By halftime, it's a 35-point lead. The starters come out as the Spartans stay laid back on the sideline.
You broke that kid's ankles on that move down there. You ever seen SpongeBob?
That's my favorite show.
Okay, well, see, now Mr. Krabs has just a little, that's what his ankles look like.
And you really kind of seized the, you seized an opportunity to come together as a team and to play good, hard football. And that was good to see.
What else is good to see is that Boss Tagaloa made it through the game with his broken finger. A fact Coach Allenbaugh doesn't let go unnoticed. Again.
So, Mark, another win in the books for De La Salle. That's 264 and counting against the North State. They're on a streak. They're going for it. Guys, keep it going.
Yeah, doing well.
All right, Synergy Environmental Solutions cleans up environmental hazards, asbestos, mold, and all the dirty work for Bay Area schools, corporations, and homes. So each week, Synergy honors the athletes who do the dirty work on the field. This week, doing the dirty work is the offensive line for the Bellarmine Bells.
The line doing a great job in the trenches, opening big holes for the backs and quarterback Troy Martig in the Bells League opening win last week. The Bells O-line doing the dirty work, just like Synergy Environmental Solutions.
Remember, you can buy DVD copies of every game you see on the show tonight. Just go to our website, CalHighSportsBayArea.com, and your game is right there.
All of our show elements and the entire show can be seen on our YouTube site, and be sure to follow us on Twitter at CalHighSportsBA is our handle, and we now have well over 10,000 followers.
Coming up, two undefeated teams on the peninsula as Woodside meets Menlo.
And volleyball in the Diablo Valley League as Clayton Valley meets Burien Christian.
Club sport at the Silver Creek Sportsplex is fitness for the entire family. Mom can feel secure in one of 120 individual fitness classes while the children play in the child care center or learn to swim in the club sport pool. Dad gets a great workout in the state-of-the-art cardio and weight training area. Classes range from Zumba to aquatics and everything in between. No matter what your fitness goals are, Club Sport welcomes everyone. Club Sport San Jose has something for the entire family. Defcon Construction is number one in the Bay Area and Silicon Valley because of trust. 95% of our business comes from repeat customers. They know the customer is our top priority. That's why Defcon was the choice for the 49ers' new stadium and for the new Earthquake Stadium. Defcon was also chosen when outstanding schools like Bellarmine, St. Francis, St. Ignatius, and Mitty wanted the very best, on time and on budget. Top Bay Area companies know Defcon is the best choice, whether it's new construction or renovation. Defcon Construction, helping to build the best in Silicon Valley.
I definitely got a lot faster. A couple days after I did my first class, I improved my 60 time at a showcase by 0.3 seconds, which is outstanding. Well, definitely working on the form component. I usually run upright where you're supposed to have your chest at a 45 degree angle. We worked on that and worked on until I could actually feel myself when I did something wrong. But definitely that improved 60 time helped, and a lot of coaches came up to me and talked to me after that. It doesn't matter whether you're the biggest guy or the smallest guy in the gym. You're always treated the same, and it's just a great place to be.
If you have not seen a hockey game live, you gotta go. I've had friends who've never seen a game live, and I'll bring them to the game, and I'll say, this is Sharks territory. It's thrilling, it's exciting, and you'll be amazed at how fast it is and how powerful the players are on the ice. You know, it's a little rough.
very physical. There's so much energy. You have to come and experience it.
This is Dr. Michael Miklich of Muir Orthopedic Specialists on the sideline with the Monta Vista High School Mustangs. And you're watching Cal High Sports Bay Area.
Back at Sportsplex in a trip to the Peninsula League Ocean Division, where both Menlo and Woodside were a perfect 4-0 to start league play. Woodside featuring outstanding senior quarterback Scudder Stockwell, one of the best names in football.
Scudder Stockwell. Can't say it any more than that. He might be good.
I wish he wouldn't.
He might be good, but Menlo has a fine QB of their own, Mackenzie Moorhead. He's thrown for over 1,000 yards for the Knights. Good matchup at Menlo Friday afternoon.
Chewbacca and his buddies celebrating homecoming at Menlo High School. First quarter, Mackenzie Moorhead finds Antonio Lopez Jr. for a 13-yard catch, setting up the Menlo Knights in Woodside Wildcat territory. Later in the drive, Moorhead hands it off to Charlie Ferguson, and Fergie runs 5 yards to give the Knights a 7-0 lead. Second quarter, Cats down by 14. Scudder Stockwell trying to get something going, fakes everyone and dives his way into the end zone. Late in the second, Cats in the red zone trying to tie the game before the half. Sione Halaapiapi rams his way in. The Cats trying to even the score, going for two. Halaapiapi does it again, and we're tied at 14 all. Early third quarter, Woodside on the move again, but Menlo's Aiden Israelsi steps in front and gets the pick, and the Knights are on their way. And Menlo takes off from there midway through the third. Now Moorhead connects with Evan King. It's a 15-yard touchdown play, 21-20 Menlo in the fourth. Now Ferguson puts the cherry on the sundae for Menlo with a 60-yard run all the way to the house. Terrific play there. Charlie Ferguson showing his skills for the Menlo Knights as Menlo goes on to win it 35-20. When Charlie finally gets into the end zone, a big win for the Knights at home. On homecoming, 200 yards passing for Moorhead.
Nothing ugly about these Eagles as they entertain the crowd. To the game, which was between Clayton Valley and Barron Christian, the ugly Eagles rolling early. Mia Mudlier to Tori Clough for the kill. Barron Christian comes right back. Michaela Sherrata with the dig. Rebecca Jones with the backside. And it's Peyton Green finishing off the action to keep the set close. But the ugly Eagles would break through in the end. Mudlier goes back and finds Shelby Pastorini, who goes off speed, and that tools the block and gives Clayton Valley a 25-19 set one win. In the second, Mudlier again utilizing the right side to her advantage, but this time finds Alyssa Guevara for the kill as the ugly Eagles begin to pull away. And then it's Jessica Stratton with the dig. Madison Downs in for the set, and Erica Schaefer hammers it home from the outside. 25-14 to Clayton Valley in set two. Keeping their foot on the gas pedal, it's exactly what the Eagles did. This time a triple block in the middle led by the star. Well, actually, her name is Star Avon, but nonetheless, she gets the block. And the ugly Eagles would bring this game to a close here. Mudlier to Kayla Catton on the outside, and Clayton Valley takes this one in straight sets, maintaining their perfect league record at 5-0.
Each week, May Industries honors a team of excellence that is doing great work, just like the construction work being done for more than 40 years by May Industries. This week's May Industries team of excellence is the Clayton Valley football team. The Ugly Eagles are having a beautiful season, picking up a huge win last week. Coach Tim Murphy is doing a fine job year after year for the Uglies, and that's why they're our May Industries team of excellence.
Coming up, the best in girls volleyball as Mitty meets St. Francis.
But first, here's our Chevron Top 10 football. Ball pull.
Cal High Sports Bay Area is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. By Wells Fargo, proud sponsor of the Game of the Week. By Lexus of Stevens Creek. Lexus of Stevens Creek is once again sponsoring the Volunteer Scholarship Award. 5 scholarships worth a total of $10,000 will be handed out at the annual Cal High Sports Banquet. By Tony and Alba's Pizza and Pasta, come check out our sports event packages. And by the Rika Center, where goals and dreams become a reality.
Back at the Silver Creek Sportsplex with West Catholic League volleyball action. This league is one of the toughest in the nation, with 4 teams ranked in the top 100 nationally, and all of them have top talent.
Yeah, all from the same league. The talent on display this week as Mitty hosted St. Francis.
I believe believe that we will win. Yes, that's what the Monarchs believe. In first set action, we feature great defense by St. Francis. Jenna Adams with the dig up to Amanda Hubbard out to Molly Everton, who hits the tough cross-court winner to pace the Lancers. Later on, great dig by Julia Chizanskos, but check out the hang time by Cameron Coley. Changes her mind at the last minute and puts it in the perfect spot. Still in the first, Julia Devine to Tessie Powers, back to Devine, and Devine intervention works well as the Monarchs took control. But this would go down to the wire. Kate Formenko with the dig, Lauren Speckman with the set, and Nicole Little pounds it away. Mitty takes set one, 26-24. Set two, all Monarchs. Chizanskos and Candace Denny team up for the roof, and then it's Powers to Denny on the slide. No stopping that. Monarchs take set two, 25-18. Set three, more of the same. Powers to Chizanskos, rips it line. She finished with 7 kills on the night, and the Monarchs finish it off in style. Chizanskos with the dig, a great push by Speckman, and Little finishes it off as she did all night long. 10 kills on the night for her. Mitty wins in straight sets to remain undefeated in the West Catholic League.
The Pioneer boys water polo team is having an outstanding season.
The boys meeting at the Rikers Center this week to talk with our Jack Washer.
We're at the Rikers Center here on Edison Way in Menlo Park, the Rikers Center, where goals are achieved.
Well, here they are behind me, the Pioneer boys water polo team. Let's get to know them. We're here with Jake Langer. Jake, you've become a great goal scorer this year. Obviously, last year you're probably a good goal scorer. So what steps did you take from last year to this year to become great?
I really focused on making separation with my defenders and reading the goalie to find out where I should place the ball.
In the middle here, Dominic Bandoni. Dominic, your coach describes you as a playmaker. When you hear the word playmaker, what comes to mind? What do you have to do in the water to be a playmaker?
When I'm in the water, I have to be able to see situations and tell people the best, what they should do in the situation. The thing that's going to work best, usually, to get it to Jake, or if I'm on the outside, the 2 and 4, Amir Grayson, to shoot the ball in.
Awesome. And this team is not fit without a goalie and a big goalie, a nice tall goalie, Noah Michaels here. Noah, goalie is probably the toughest position in water polo to play because, honestly, you're just standing there treading water all day. What does it take to be a great goalie in water polo?
Just strong legs and quick reaction time and the ability to start the offense and communicate to your team.
You talk about starting the offense. I saw a lot of plays last week where you were throwing the ball down the field, starting with a full court pass. Is that something you're looking to do each and every time you get the ball or make a save?
I try to look as far down the pool as I can to make it easier for our guys to score a goal. But if I can't, whoever is the most open is the guy that's going to get the ball.
Awesome. Well, thanks, guys. Best of luck the rest of the year, and the floor is yours.
Hey, Mustangs on 3, 1, 2, 3. Mustangs!
DGDG.com is with us this season, and once again, they bring us the Be Happy Play.
This week's Be Happy Play goes to Akalanis and sudden death. Lexi Raw puts it in the net, and the girls can't help but be excited and show their love to Lexi in this week's Be Happy Play.
Go to DGDG.com to find out how you can be a happy car buyer.
Coming up, it's the play of the week. Here's one of the contenders. We'll announce the winner next.
But first, here is this week's training tip by our good friends at the Rikers Center.
Hi, I'm Coach Robbie, and today's training tip is a half kneel to standing press. Our starting position is going to be half kneel. Feel free to use a towel or pad to protect your knee. We're going to take the right arm, bring it out. Elbow is going to be at a 90 degree angle. She's going to be pressing through her front heel, standing up as she drives her arm up towards the ceiling, making sure that her glutes and core are engaged to help keep a neutral spine. She'll then return to the ground and continue. We'll do about 8 repetitions and then make sure that you repeat on the other side.
Once again this season, the winner of the Play of the Week receives an invitation to our end of the season awards banquet.
We like to show some contenders first and then, of course, the winner. So let's see what top plays we have this week.
We start plays of the week with the man himself, Buddha Eisen. Just one of Buddha's hard-fought runs in a big league game. Only a junior, we look forward to watching him do big things. Campo's Zoe Crouch making this shot look far too easy. Perfect placement to tie the game up, causing OT. Mitty's Julia Devine is quite divine with this monstrous kill. Watch out for Julia. Pitt's Ajay Boyd doing exactly what the coaches had in mind, making the catch and taking the ball 44 yards to the house to win the game in the final minute. Nate Galley a happy, happy coach. Burlingame's Giovanni Garcia doing his job on special teams. Giovanni hustling upfield, going right through defenders, and we don't have too much time, so we fast forward a little, get the guy some oxygen, and we have arrived at the play of the week. Gio Faulu from Freedom not only makes the crazy one-handed grab, but then manages to turn it into a touchdown. This play was too good that we needed to slow down the catch, and then the extension in this week's play of the week.
That's the play of the week, and that's Cal High Sports Bay Area for this week. Thanks for watching. I'm Robert Bronstein.
And I'm Marissa Lovis. Join us next week when we see if De La Salle can hang with one of the top teams in the state, as the regular season with De La Salle is more than halfway done. We'll see you then.